What is the quarantine game mode, you might be asking yourself? Well, to get straight to the point, it's an infection game mode that I created a good hot minute ago. And it isn't just any same old version of the same old infection. It was specifically made to be unique. To give you some backstory, I'm a huge fan of zombies and zombie type games. Around the time that Halo 2 was already big on the scene, a custom game mode was created simply called Zombies. Due to how Halo 2 worked, you were still limited in what you could do with that type of creativity, just pistols and shotguns. And with this mode, it was all based around the honor system of switching sides by yourself because it wasn't automatic. I absolutely loved it. But I couldn't help to think that we could do more to make it interesting. So, I added more stuff for the survivors, including the battle rifle and power weapons as pickups on the map. It really mixed things up, and my small group of friends really enjoyed it too, so I had to give it a name that had zombie inspiration. But it had to be different. I call that game mode Quarantine. Then, Halo 3 released and blew everyone's mind with Forge. Placeable objects, new locations for weapons wherever you wanted on the map. It was amazing. Little did we know how much this would actually change the way we would look at maps and game types. Plus, this was the start of the official version of zombies in matchmaking, now called Infection. I messed around with it myself and eventually thought about making my own maps. I thought about making some competitive stuff initially, but figured that it wasn't as fun and I wasn't creative enough in that area. I then ended up revisiting that same idea from Halo 2. So I cranked up High Ground and went to work. I must have put in multiple hours on hours just trying to figure out how I wanted it all to look. To weapon placements, to everything else. To help separate Quarantine from the rest of the Infection game modes, I purposely put equipment, grenades, weapons all around the map in new locations to make it still feel like a regular Halo map, but it also rewarded players for exploring as well. The map ended up being a personal success and some of the most fun I've ever had in Halo 3. I went and created some more maps within Halo 3, but eventually stopped with Halo Reach as I tried and failed to create some Halo 2 maps. My interest level to create maps drew down with each new Halo release alongside my friends that stopped playing the games altogether. It wasn't until recently that I saw brand new objects getting included into Forge with the Master Chief Collection updates, and it sparked my interest in it once again. With that said, I plan on releasing a few walkthrough videos of these maps alongside downloadable links for them as well. And maybe work on more in anticipation of Halo Infinite coming out just around the corner. That's all I have for today. Sneak Squad, I'll see you next video.